I want people to hear my heart and to know what my ministry is all about and what Christ has done for me in a nutshell. I was born with an underdeveloped right eye, and I also was born with just the left side of my nose. I'm from a very loving and caring family, so I had a really good home base. But when I stepped out of the doors, the teasing started when I started kindergarten. And I learned that words can be a blessing or they can be a curse. And the words that were spoken to me, you're ugly, you're worthless, those words went right into my heart and I didn't know how to deal with them. The hardest thing for me growing up was feeling alone, because I didn't have a lot of friends. I had my family there to encourage me and they were wonderful. But walking to school, walking home from school, standing out in the yard at recess, that was hard because I didn't know what to do about it. There was no answer for me. And I often wondered, like, how is my life going to pan out? When I was in grade 3, we had a reading contest in school, and I won the female version of the reading contest. It was a king and a queen. I won the queen, and I got to wear a little pink tissue paper crown, and I was so excited. And I went out at recess, because I'd never won anything before, but I went out at recess, and I was standing there beside the door, and a little girl walked up to me, and she said, "You're not fit to be a queen." And those words just went right into my heart. And I remember taking the little crown off. I don't know what I ever did with it. But that just is a little sample of what the words did to me. It just, the little bit of hope that I had there, those words just knocked them right down. From the time I was 2.5 till I was 18, they did plastic surgeries every, I don't know, I'm not sure how many, 20, 25, I'm not sure. Till I was 18. Gave my heart to Christ when I was 22, and he started doing a healing in my heart. And it's been a process, and it's still a process, but I had to forgive those that hurt me before I could move on, before God could use me, and before God could heal my heart. And now when I look back, it's like I'm looking at somebody else. It doesn't hurt anymore. When I became a Christian, I used to buy accompaniment cassettes. That tells how old I am. And I'd buy them from the Christian bookstore, and I'd sit in my bedroom and I'd sing songs. And that's where I thought my music would go. God opened a door for me to be involved with a Christian motorcycle club. So they let me go on their runs with them to their engagements, and they knew that I loved to sing, and they'd say, "Carol, bring some of your cassettes along." And they would have guys share their testimonies, and then they'd say, now Carol is going to sing. And then the pastors heard me sing, and they started saying, "Carol, we want you to come on your own to sing." And because of the words that were spoken to me all my life, that I was no good, that I was a failure, that I was worthless, it took me a long time to realize that God had given me a gift to sing. And now you can't shut me up. Well, right now I'm in the process of recording a new CD. When I prayed and asked God to take me to the brokenhearted, one of the things he did was take me to seniors' homes. But I also share in women's conferences and services and church services and luncheons, things like that. A lot of the time I share my story, but I also weave music into my story. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope." And he has that for each person. We just need to reach out to him for it. You can't find it in the world. You will not find it in the world. It is only through knowing Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and asking him to come into your heart. Well, God has shown me very clearly that I am not worthless, that I have much worth. I am, in his eyes, I am priceless and precious. About 10 years ago, actually, I was back at my home church, went to my mailbox. I found a paper crown that a child had made and stuck it in my mailbox. It was a God thing. I went into the sanctuary and I was going to be singing that day. And I thought, I'll be silly and I'll put the crown on and go up to the front when it's time to sing and it'll make them laugh. As I sat there with that crown beside me, tears started to come every time I'd look at the crown. And I just said, "God, why is this crown making me cry?" And I heard his still small voice And he said, Carol, I am restoring your crown. And that's what he has done.